tears don't fall in outer space. They appear like bubbles of grief sweat. One bubble may push another aside, but they cling to your face unless you shake them loose, and even then they hover in a salty, partly atomized cloud of droplets. So many dizzying trajectories circling your head like unnamed moons. It takes something like gravity to give them a sense of direction and flow. Without a concert master like that, they just pile up like a watery traffic jam. And after a while, where are you? Another example of weightless phenomena is the candle flame, which on Earth burns in an elongated teardrop. In the presence of gravity, lighter gases rise. Convection currents apply. In zero G, candle flames are perfect balls. Like the sun, we see our lives stretched between poles of birth and death. Were we free of bias and judgmentalism, they'd radiate equally in all directions at once. And lastly, there was the buildup of carbon dioxide, like accreting helmets of frog spittle about the heads of sleeping astronauts, velcroed to space station walls, till the problem was identified, and little fans were trained on scientifically dreamy faces. Once again, in zero G, the heavier carbon dioxide is not heavier, cannot drain or diffuse. Clearly, we're earthly stuff, consigned to a menu of planetary stresses. Is there nothing that can ease gravity's constant graveyard pull? Only a healing flame, burning in all directions at once, that bears the name of love. Tears don't fall in outer space.